on the radio station now if they're ready.
Won a toss.
A toggle did.
A toggle? They defer?
Yes.
Okay.
No, I think they said receive.
Okay.
I gotta check audio.
Check, check.
We on the radio yet?
Yep, we are.
Welcome, Cougar fans. This is Ben White along with Spence Overton and Tim Doerr. We are here today at Veteran Memorial Stadium bringing you the live coverage of the AISA 2A high school football final game of the season. Spence, state championship game played at Larry Blakely Field. Matchup today between the Escambia Academy Cougars and the Otauga Academy Generals. These two teams, Spence, are no stranger to each other. They've met several times here over the last few years.
Yeah, they did. Last year, same field, about the same time. And it didn't go so well for the Cougars. And there, a lot of kids were turning off that team last year, looking to change the outcome of this game.
Escambia Academy coming in tonight's game, or today's game, rather, with a record of 9-3. Otauga coming into the game, a record of 8-2. Both sides, almost a rivalry game, you could say, between the two. So tensions are high and expectations are high as well from both sides.
Yeah, both teams have really strong offenses and defenses. Otauga has scored 474 points total this year in their 10 games, with an average of 47.4 points per game. Their defense has only given up 183 points with an average of 18.3.
I'm going to take a moment for the implication. We'll be right back to you.
That lady.
And a beautiful rendition of the Star Spangled Banner that was, Spence.
Yes, it was.
All right, as we approach the kickoff, the Escambia Academy Cougars won the toss and deferred to the second half.
Okay, just finishing up where we were before we took the break. Escambia Academy scores an average of 436 points this season, which is an average of 36.3 points per game. And they've only given up 162 total points, which is an average of 13.5 points per game. So this is setting up to be a great one. You've got two offensive teams with great defenses.
And you couldn't ask for better weather for a game such as this. Spence, 72 degrees here. At the Veterans Memorial Stadium. Slight wind out of the south, about 6 miles per hour. Cougars are coming out today dressed in the red jerseys, the red home jerseys with the gold lettering in the red helmets, the red pants. Watauga Generals are coming out with the black pants and the white jerseys with the black lettering and the white and black striped helmets with the gold trim. Orlando Medina set to kick it away to get this ball game underway. Here's the approach and the kick. It's going to be a deep, wobbly kick, going to land about the 10-yard line. Bounce to the five where it's picked up. Brought right up the middle of the field, tried to hit the wedge, kicked it out, hit, slings it off tackle, and covered up by Cougars at the 11-yard line. No flags on the play, Spence. It looks like the Generals will start from their own territory deep at the 11-yard line. First down and 10. Cougar, the Generals will be actually traveling from left to right. Today we're actually situated on the home side. We have Generals come out showing twins on the near side. Single wide out to the far side. Man now in motion to the far side. Quarterback from the shotgun looking to pass, pumping, throws, got a man on him. Hit in the backfield at number 11. By number 11. No gain, maybe even a 1 yard loss, Vince.
Yeah, that was Trey Cutler on the carry reception there. And he's one of their key players. We'll probably be calling his name a lot tonight. Coach said they had a plan to bring the big guy down. And it worked on that play.
Palmer's in at quarterback. Twins on the near side. His running back, number 11, lined up to his right side, Trey Cutler. Trey Cutler is a big fella, like he was just mentioning, Spence. He's 5'10", 265 pounds. And already a flag against the Cougars. What was that about?
The defense jumped off. They do that little come up and get ready and look to the sideline for the play. And looks like Randall Bonds just got a little over-anxious and jumped there.
It's going to bring up second down to 7. We got twins on the near side. Palmer from the shotgun. Here's a snap. Hands off to number 11 in the backfield. Hit in the backfield. Missed the tackle and picks up about a yard before he's brought down on the far side. Bryant Quimby was in the backfield, had his hands on him, just couldn't get him down.
Yeah, that's a big fella. He's listed at 275, 265 on paper. He's lost 10 pounds from last year. Anyway, he's very quick. He's built low to the ground, and it's going to take a lot of low tackles because he'll run through those arm tackles, and I think that's kind of what happened. We got him up high, and he just ran right through it, but the next guy got him down low.
Palmer has a shotgun. Single wide out, though, actually twins on the far side. Single twins on the near side. From the shotgun, looking deep, looking past. Guy throws across the middle on the slant pattern. Hits number 4. He picks up to the 20, to the 25. Run out of bounds at the 27-yard line.
Good enough for the first down.
And the sticks will move. The Generals keep this drive alive and move it. First down and 10. Looks like they are spotting it on the 28. Single wide out, split far to the far side. Palmer in the shotgun. Hands off in the backfield to number 11, which brought down at the line of scrimmage.
That was number 3, Landon Sims in. He's getting up a little slow. Hopefully he's okay.
We don't need Sims hurt, especially this early in the ball game. What is he holding? Was it a hand or his knee?
I'm not sure.
Coach sees that, and he's going to pull him out for a moment.
J.J. Stevens checks in.
Trey Cutler is also limping off the field from Autauga.
Yeah, he don't like to get hit down low, and they're attacking them knees right now. I see him over there grabbing his knee.
That's number 10 in at quarterback, isn't it? Tyson Freshman. Takes it around to the far side.
Holding,
not called, but brought down at the line of scrimmage.
J-Bo Davis in on that stop. Made a great open field stop on number 10, the quarterback.
That was Tyson Freeman, the wide receiver and defensive back, also coming in, checked in the quarterback position, running the Wildcat, tried to get wide, couldn't. Stopped at the line of scrimmage. Cougars defense ready for today's game so far. Brings up third down and 8. Ball's just across the 30 to the 31. From the shotgun, Palmer has it. Looking to pass in the pocket, looking deep, pumps, got pressure, tosses it. And hits his man over on the sideline at the 43-yard line. It is caught inbounds, and he gets out of bounds for the first down.
That's number 88, Webster there. Big tall receiver.
Had to look twice to make sure he got his foot in the bounds, but he did. First down and 10. Now ball on the general 47-yard line, 48-yard line. From the shotgun, Palmer's looking deep, got pressure. Having a scramble, looking forward, and caught in the backfield for a sack.
It looked like Randall Bonds and Jason Helton and Landon Sims getting up off of that pile for a loss of 3 on that play.
Brings up second down and 12. It appears where the down marker is. On the 41-yard line. Cougars defense definitely showing aggression. not wanting to give him much time, because if you give Palmer time to pass, he's got plenty of receivers that can catch the ball, got plenty of speed. We've got twins on the near side.
Cutler in the back.
For the shotgun, Palmer hands it off to number 11 in the backfield. And a host of Cougars bring him down. I don't think he picked up anything, Spence.
I don't think he did either.
If he did, it was inches. They did move the down marker about a foot.
Like Brian Quimby got in on that and brought the big fella down.
Third down and 11. Big third down play for the Generals here. Ball game just underway. Quarter, the first quarter, 7 minutes, 44 seconds on the clock. Ball spotted on the near side hash mark, 42-yard line, General territory.
Number 11 comes out to split in out here. Farthest man to the near side.
Nobody in the backfield but Palmer. Palmer's looking to pass. Got pressure. Dumps it off in the flats. Over number four. Four slips down. Lost his foot. He may have got enough of the first down if he had not have slipped on the turf. That was number four, Teddy Harris, 5'8" wide receiver for the Generals. Brings up fourth down and 5 for the Generals.
I talked to Coach earlier in the pregame. He said they don't punt a lot. He said if they do line up, they're probably going to fake it. Looks like they're lining up to go for it. That's setting a big statement here for Otago early.
Twins on the near side, Palmer in the shotgun. He's got big number 11, Trey Cutler, to his right. Cougars are ready. Here's a snap. Palmer looking to pass. Another dump pass across the middle. Does he catch it?
Yes, he caught it
he
for
caught
the first
it.
Down.
First down.
It was good coverage there by Ty Williams. It just receiver was able to hang on to the ball and pick up the first down.
That was a phenomenal catch. I didn't think he had it for a moment, but I guess the ref had a better view of it than I did. I was looking at him from the back. First down and 10 now in Cougar territory. Ball's on the 45-yard line. Generals moving from left to right. From the shotgun, Palmer. Flanked to his right by Cutler, his running back. Low snap, picks it up. Throws it deep, looking deep.
Got a man.
Number 6 is open, but good coverage knocks the ball away.
Shannon Wheat on the coverage there. The throw was accurate. The receiver was in position. Shannon just came in at the last minute, and I don't know if he got his hand up or not, but it was enough to distract the receiver, and the ball just got down.
Number 6, Raymond Cutler, was the intended receiver. He was down there. He had about 2 steps on Shannon Wheat, but Wheat was able to adjust and get there right before the ball was caught, so probably saved the touchdown. This time, General just showing single wide on the far side and twins on the near side. We have Palmer in the backfield from the shotgun with a single running back. Hands up, no, fakes it, looking pass, throws it, caught, and brought down by Dr. McGee after crossing the 40 to the 38-yard line.
That was big number 88, Webster, on the catch there.
Generals have it now, 3rd down and 4. They got to make it to the 35. Actually, 3rd down and 3. The ball is on.
37?
Yeah, 37-yard line. Timeout is called on the field. Who's the bye?
Looks like some confusion there on the Tigers' offense, and coach decided to take a timeout.
Tigers calls the first timeout of the ball game with 5 minutes, 34 seconds on the clock. Score at the moment, 0-0. We're going to take 60 seconds, head back to WBZR 105.9. Spence, the crowd is in this ball game so far.
Yeah, I expect a good game here. As was the first one. We watched the third and fourth quarters of the first game, the Class 1A state championship, and it was 0-0 when we got here, and it ended up being a 14-8 final in that game. I expect this one to be, I mean, these are the best 6 teams in the AISA playing today, and I expect to be a good game.
So far, the Otago has 4 rushing yards and 40 pass yards. It's a total of 44 yards so far. It is 3rd down and 3 yards to go. Ball's on the 38-yard line. This time, number 10 is back in the backfield. That's Tyresham freshman. Fakes the handoff. He keeps it, runs around, gets blocked by the Cougars.
Holding.
And tries to get around the end. Does he make it? He makes it around the end to the 35-yard line was run out of bounds. Was it enough for the first? It looks like it was. Sticks will move yet again. Otago stays alive.
They had J.J. Stevens, three or four handfuls of jersey on him and wouldn't let him go. He was all over the play. I don't know why the ref didn't see it to make that call. They had him stopped in the backfield.
Otago first and 10, ball's on the 33-yard line. Starting to get deeper into Cougar territory. Looks like the Generals are sending twins on the far side and the near side. We got a single up, man now in motion. Quick pass, little screen pass off the number six in the backfield. He'll pick up about seven. No, he saw it on his feet inside. Knocked out at the 5-yard line. I thought he stepped out of bounds way back there, but apparently he didn't.
That's number six. Was that Tyquell Taylor on the stop? Is that right? I don't have our roster today.
Tyquell Taylor, number six, stop number six.
For a big game.
Almost stopped on the play. I thought he stepped out way back there, but they didn't. First down and goal, 10-yard line. Hands off, big number 10 in the backfield. He runs forward across the five to the four. It's going to bring up second down and goal for the Generals. That last play really hurt us.
Yes, it did.
Second down and goal. Now hands off up the middle to Cutler again. Cutler
flag.
Flags in the flying in the air.
I believe that's going to be a legal procedure against the Otago. It didn't like they had everybody set on a play. It was in that quick hurry up, and they just got a little bit ahead of themselves. Oh, no, we're going to have a timeout. Cougars.
Cougars called timeout before the play got off. That's good. All right, they're going to take 60 seconds, talk about it. We will take 60 seconds, head back to WBZR 105.9. I'd love to be on the field listening to what Coach Sims has to say at the moment.
Is that the 4-yard line the ball spotted at?
Ball's on the 4-yard line. Second down.
Trying to keep some stats here as the game goes on.
If you're just joining us, we got 4 minutes and 45 seconds on the clock for the first quarter. Scores 0-0 at the moment, but the Generals are deep in Cougar territory. Second down with 4 yards to go. Looks like number 10 comes back in from the Wildcat. That's Tyresham freshman, a Freeman rather. Seeing empty backfield. Now man in motion to the near side. Going to hand off to
number six.
Guy going the opposite direction. That was number six.
Jason Hilton got in there. He read that play and then caught him in the backfield and stopped it.
We have an injured player on the field too. Big J-Bo Davis took down number 52 and that helmet popped off. So he'll have to come out for a few seconds.
Hopefully they didn't see that.
Little misdirection. That's old Raymond Cutler for the Generals was the ball carrier that time. And brought down.
The Otago's got 19 seniors on this team. The whole starting line are seniors this year.
Off screen, you're not seeing some interaction between Mike Sims and Coach Bobby Carr.
Yeah, this is a rivalry. You know, as many of you know, Coach Sims came from Otago. So not only is this a rivalry game between the teams, you also got some personal rivalries going on there.
Ball's backed up on that last play to the 7-yard line. Now third down and goal from the 7. That's number 10, Freeman back in the Wildcat. Empty backfield. Man now in motion near side. Fakes it to him. Looking to pass.
Wide open.
In his own, but the pass is incomplete.
He had pressure on him by Landon Sims there, and he rushed that throw, and number 88 was wide open for the touchdown, and just the pass was short and hit the ground.
There wasn't anybody within 2 car lengths.
88's a big guy, but he just can't do anything with them low passes.
Sure can't. That's a big play for the Cougars. Hope they need to stop them here. Fourth down and goal from a 7. This will be a big statement for the Cougar defense if we can keep them out of the end zone.
Just go.
3 minutes, 32 seconds left to go in the first quarter. Score 0-0. Now we have Palmer back in a shotgun.
Look for the fade right here.
Looking to pass, got pressure. He's going to try to take it himself.
Got him. Turnover.
Take it down, baby.
Shut him down. Big J.J. Stevens in on the stop there, number 59.
So the Cougars will take over on downs deep in their own territory at the 9-yard line. Big stop by the Cougar defense. Score remains 0-0, but this time the ball is going the opposite direction. I believe the crowd right around us approves of the stop as well.
Well, you know, maybe that timeout was well used. Coach got them fired up, and the defense shut them down.
They sure did.
And we got some white hats over here talking to Coach about something. Apparently they don't like something that's going on, so they're discussing it.
Landon Sims is in the backfield. Who's that on the far side? It's Ty Williams wide out on the far side.
That's Ty Williams and Tyquell Taylor. And looks like Daltrey McGee in at the running back position.
Brian Quimby this time is going to be tight on the left side.
I see number 56. Mine went blank there for a second. Back from being injured.
Brady Howell.
Brady Howell, yes. Brady's back. He missed the last two games injured. He's back tonight or today.
Referee puts the ball back in play. Sims from the shotgun, empty backfield. Oops, excuse me, got Daltrey McGee in the backfield. Hands off to McGee up the middle. He picked up about four before he's brought down. Brings it all the way out to around the 14, maybe 15-yard line. Looks like the line judge has spotted it, has his foot planted just on the inside the 15-yard line. Sims staying in the shotgun. This time we have our twins coming to the near side. That's Tekeel Taylor and Ty Williams both on the near side. Brian Quimby stays tight. Dr. McGee.
5 seconds.
To the left of Sims. Sims going to keep it this time. Take it up the middle. Gets hit by the linebacker in the backfield. And he'll make it forward to the 19-yard line before his forward progress is stopped.
That was Cutler, I think, made the first initial contact on Sims there.
I was close to the first down, but I don't believe he got it.
Yes, yeah. They did. Moving the sticks.
First down and 10 from the 19.
We got Sam Fields checking in.
2 minutes, 26 seconds left to go in the first quarter. Ty Williams, that's Tyquell Taylor, wide out to the near side. Ty Williams on the far side.
I'm not sure what's going on here. We have to call timeout. Sims may be a little shaken up on that play.
A little bit of confusion, so the Cougars will call timeout. With 2 minutes, 10 seconds left to go in the first quarter, score remaining 0-0. Cougars
helmet
have
issues.
The ball.
I have a helmet issue.
He broke a snap, I think, on his helmet. They had to call timeout there. Well, it's 2:10 left in the first quarter, and Cougars have already used two timeouts. But they've been well used.
They have. Otago's already used one. Cougars have used two.
I'm sitting here writing, trying to keep up with little stats as we go along. And I guess I'm just so nervous or hyped up or something. I'm shaking.
I see your paperwork, and that's some fine chicken scratch you got going on right there.
I'm telling you, I may need somebody to translate it at halftime.
I'm looking at what you're writing now. I'm thinking, Spence, you should have probably went to medical school. You've been a fine doctor based on your handwriting.
Well, I'm a carpenter. Most of my writing is on a straight line.
I've seen your straight lines. Back in play now. We have first down and 10. Ball on the Cougar 19. Cougars have the ball. This time we have Petey McCants wide out to the near side. I can't tell who's on the far side.
That's Ty Williams on the far side. Looks hand like, off to. Oh.
Looks like Sims was hit at the line of scrimmage and brought back.
I thought he handed off to Jabo up the middle there, and he pulled it at the last second, and they read it.
Well, I did too. I went with Jabo. But I saw the crowd keep pushing backwards. That's a loss on the play. Second down and 12. Looks like actually 13.
As you coach the game of football, you teach them to go hard till the whistle blows. But I think they teach them in a talking to go a couple seconds after the whistle blows because they sure aren't slowing down when it blows.
Ball's on the 17-yard line. Second down and 12. Sims from the shotgun. Here's a snap, rolling left, looking deep, got pressure, throws it off into the stands.
They hit him out late there.
Incomplete pass. Bring up third down and 13 for the Cougars. 1 minute, 17 seconds left to go in the first quarter. Spence, Cougars haven't been able to put together much offense so far.
Well, we knew it was going to be a defensive game based on the stats.
We have Petey McCants and Tyler Cloud wide out on the near side. With Ty Williams on the far side, we have Landon Sims in the backfield from the shotgun. Hands off. No. Hands off to Jabo. Jabo brings it out across the 25, almost to the 30. No, almost to the 25 at the 24. 23, where they stopped. No, 27.
So that's going to be our first punt of the evening.
This angle's got me messed up on my yardage.
Yeah, it does.
Who picked this spot?
I'm not sure. Landon Sims will be back, standing on his own 10-yard line. Nope, backing on up a little bit further to punt it away for the Cougars.
Otago's had a history of running back our returns here.
Almost dropped that one, almost blocked as well, but it gets it off and it goes out of bounds.
Not a very good punt. They're running into the kicker. That's going to give us a first down.
There you go.
Thank you, referee.
So what turned out to be a not-so-great punt because it goes out of bounds pretty quickly turns out to be a pretty decent play for us because we end up getting a penalty in the first down.
I was wondering if those refs had any flags in their pockets, but now he's waving it off.
Is he waving the flag off?
Yes, he is. So that's going to be about a 22-yard punt.
Well, goodness. So that penalty was waved off, so the Generals will take over now. First down and 10, going back the other way. Ball inside Cougar territory at the 42-yard line. Palmer in at quarterback at shotgun. He's got twins on the near side, a single wide out on the far side. Rolls out, fakes to his running back. Throws, looking deep, throwing deep. Little scuffle in the backfield, and that's going to be a pass interference. Looks like Bryant Quimby got tied up with the intended receiver about the 30-yard line, and the referee was standing there looking at it.
Well, as I always say, if you beat, take the 15 and live to play again, and I think that's what happened there. He got behind Bryant, and he just knew he had one option. That's grabbing. So
I don't disagree with that at all because he would have been wide open and nobody behind him to the end zone. Now, Generals now closer, first down and 10 from the 32-yard line. Palmer from the shotgun, twins near side, man in motion near side. Looking to pass, quick pass off behind the line of scrimmage. Number 6 hits him. Flag on the play, who's that against?
It's against the target. Block in the back, number 88. He hit Ty Williams in the back. That one's coming back. Holding, what? Something to that effect. I didn't see exactly, but I saw 88 hit him in the back.
Shannon Wheat ran him out of bounds at the 15-yard line. But there's a flag laying on the 30.
Block in the back. That's what I thought. That's good. That's going to back them up.
Good call, Spence. We'll take it. That backs the Tog up all the way back up to the 34. 39, rather. First down and 17. The ball's on the 39. Generals approaching the line of scrimmage once again. This time we have Tripp going out far to the far side. Single wide out near side. Palmer with a single back in the backfield. Low snap, picks it. Looking deep, throws, got a man nowhere around. Must have been some miscommunication because the only one back there was our guy, Ty Williams.
Ty Williams, and I thought he was going to run under it to make the interception there for a second.
I was looking around. The only guy I saw with black on anywhere in the neighborhood was a referee.
Yeah, that looks like the two receivers run a crossing route, and they may have hit each other, and nobody went deep.
4 seconds left to go in the first quarter. Score remains 0-0. Ball's on the 39-yard line. Palmer back in the backfield in the shotgun, looking to pass. In pocket with pressure, throws across from the center of the field.
Flag
comes flying. Another flag comes flying.
There's flags everywhere.
All directions.
Well, apparently they can throw a flag on us, but not against them. There are some kind of holding going on that line right there, and they're just not calling it.
Well, the first flag come out from across the field early, and then the second two seem to come out about 5 seconds later. I'm wondering if it's all the same call.
Yeah, I'm thinking it is. I think the both back judges saw it because it kind of happened in the middle of the field. That's going to put
pass interference.
Otauga deep in Cougar territory.
Move the ball all the way up to the 24-yard line.
Flags. Lopsided flags. You get those flags that are even on both sides.
Yeah, and they're missing some calls, too. A couple of Otauga's big plays, there's been a lot of holding, and they're just not calling it.
So it was a holding call, not a pass interference. So second down and, what, three?
Three. Who called time? End of the quarter.
End of the quarter. That will do it for the first quarter. Scambia Academy 0, Otauga Academy 0. End of the first quarter of AISA 2A championship ball game here at Veterans Memorial Stadium, Larry Blakeney Field, in beautiful Troy, Alabama. It's beautiful February, excuse me, beautiful Friday, November 22nd.
You know, I like that scoreboard there. It helps us out with the stats. Otauga at the end of the first quarter had 76 total yards, 14 rushing, 62 passing, where the Cougars only had 14 rushing, 0 passing.
Why don't we give a shout-out to our sponsors real quick. Those who sponsored our press box was Atlas Roofing, PNR Mining, Dirt Technology, Darwin Earls, Overton Electrical Construction, Binder and Lumber, Southern Wood Specialties, the Matthews Family, Randy Dobbins, Builders, American Concrete, Sunbelt Renters. Also want to thank our corporate sponsors, Alabama Tank, Diamond Gasoline, Dirt Technology, Dr. William Harris, General Surgeon, Overton Electrical Construction, Reynolds Real Estate, Superior Petroleum Services, Sunbelt Rentals, and United Bank. And we thank those sponsors. Why, Ben?
Because they make it possible for us to bring this broadcast to them live every single week. We travel, so you don't have to.
We hope everyone came out today, though. What's our viewers looking like today?
350s.
We got quite a crowd here on the Cougar side. The ball's been swapped. The Generals will now be traveling from right to left. Second down and 3 yards to go. Ball deep inside Cougar territory at the 24-yard line.
Got a little bit of dancing out there.
Looks like Tyreshian Freeman back in a Wildcat. They've got Trips on the far side. Man lined up tight on the near side. Empty backfield. That's number 7 in motion. He's going to fake it to him, looking to pass. Going to try to keep it this time. Takes it up the middle, makes it all the way to the 10, crosses the 10 to the 7, which finally brought down, touchdown saved by Chase Bell and Shannon Wee back there.
He had number 2 wide open in the end zone, and he elected to pull it down and run it, which may have been a good call. He picked up a good bit of gain yards on that, but, man, he was wide open, jumping up and down, waving at him in the end zone.
They're going to call him down at the 10-yard line, first down and goal. Trips on the near side, same guy, number 10, Freeman, all by himself in the backfield with a man in motion to the near side. This time fakes it, keeps it, and takes it up the middle. This time he may make it to the end zone.
He does.
He does. Touchdown.
A couple missed blocks.
There was 3 people who had a hand on him, but he kept shaking and jiving and finally got loose and found the hole and took it on into the end zone for 6.
They have a kicker, number
44, I think.
Only AISA female kicker in the association.
She's pretty good. I was watching her earlier in the game.
Yeah, she's spot on.
Yeah. Emma.
Oh, guess what?
He's good.
Chase Bell comes in trying to block the kick, and there's a personal foul.
And it's got to be one going both ways.
It should.
I mean, it's got to be.
There's 2 flags come out.
Yep.
The ref's trying to find dig in his pocket. I sure hope they call that both ways, because, I mean, that was ridiculous. I mean, these are supposed to be the AISA's best officials here.
So the kick was no good.
Oh, I thought it said it went through. I was watching the jawing down here.
That's what I did. I mean, no, it was good. Kick was good. So the score is 7-0. Otago struck first with 11 minutes and 42 seconds on the clock for the in the second quarter.
Kick was good, was it not?
It yes. was good. I'm sorry.
I thought it looked good, and then I saw all this other, and I kind of lost concentration of the ball game for a second.
I looked up at the scoreboard, and they hadn't changed it, so I assumed it was no good. Because the truth is, I got to watching the scuffle and not the ball.
See, here's a white hat with the official call.
He's saying the kick is good.
Personal foul against Otago. Okay.
We'll take it.
Yeah, I think they were upset that Chase Bell kind of slid into her, and that's when he came off and went towards Chase Bell and was in his face pretty quick.
I don't think he wants to be up in Chase Bell's face. I'm going to be quite honest with you. Chase Bell, wasn't he several records in the weightlifting championships?
Yep, just a few.
That's going to back them up, kicking from deep in their own territory, so Cougars should get good field position here.
Oh, I hate being behind.
That was a should have been a 15-yard penalty, unsportsmanlike conduct, and only marking 10. Well, no, I'm sorry. I'm looking at the X from the college.
So Target tees it up on their own 25-yard line.
I would look for some trickery here.
Oh, I'd love them to try to kick an
onside
kick and they'd give us the ball.
I would too.
Pretty short.
Apparently, coach is prepared for that. I see a lot of hands teams on the front guys. Not a lot of big guys in for blocking. I think they expect it.
Talk, you just have to kick it away. Here's the kick. It's going to be fielded around the 24-yard line. Taken up the middle of the field. Taken to the far side. He hit around the 30-yard line and brought down at the 36.
Tyree Smith on that return. Was that 16 yards on that return?
16-yard return. Big Tyree Smith. He's a senior. 6 foot, 180 pounds. But you get Tyree Smith moving,
he can
he's
move.
Hard to stop.
Yes, he is. He plays nose guard, and he's also back returning kickoff. So that tells you what kind of speed he's got there. It's tough for those guys on that front line to contain him.
Cougars moving from left to right now. First down and 10 from their own 35-yard line, 36-yard line. Ty Williams and Chase Bell wide out on the near side. We got Tyquell Taylor on the far side wide out. Landon Sims in the backfield, along with Bryant Quimby and Daughtry McGee. Here's a snap, hands off to Daughtry. Daughtry takes it across the near side tackle, hit by the linebacker around the 40-yard line.
Yeah, that's big number 11 in there.
Cutler.
He's key player on both sides of the ball for the Generals.
They're spotting it on the 39s. That's a 3-yard gain. Brings up second down and 7 from the Florida Cougars. Chase Bell went to the far side along with Tyquell Taylor. Ty Williams wide out on the near side. Big Jabo Davis flanking to the right. Shannon Wheat to the left to Sims. Hands off to Wheat in the backfield. Wheat brings it around the near side. Got a block. Good. Great block. Crossing the 50 to the 45. Where he's thrown out of bounds by his jersey.
I bet it's going to be a horse collar. Either late hit out of bounds. That's going to add 15 more yards on to it.
And we will take it.
Like the Cougars are finally getting a little offense going here.
Uh-oh. I think he's going to change the play.
No, it was definitely it was either, I don't know if they called it a horse collar or a late hit out of bounds, but he threw him
He waved it off.
He waved it off, huh?
Man, I don't know.
Unbelievable!
This is ridiculous, guys. I mean, if you're not here joining us and you're watching live on Facebook, you're seeing it.
And we got to be careful with sponsors, and we get upset, but, you know, we got that AISA policy. We're supposed to make sure we don't just be discouraging about the officials. But some of these are very,
very noticeable.
Very noticeable. So if you're watching from Facebook and YouTube, you can see it too. It's just we're just going to keep on driving.
First down and 10, ball now inside general territory. Jabo Davis in motion, sets up in the slot on the far side. Sims hands off, gives it to Wheat in the backfield. Wheat brings it across the 50, stays up,
still going.
Crosses to the 46. 2-yard line. for, what, they spot at the 44?
43, I believe, is where he said his knee went down.
I thought he stayed up there, but I guess he didn't. Back to the original line of scrimmage, it appears. Maybe just behind at a tad. Second down and 10 and a half, we'll say. Autauga leading by a score of 7-0 with 10 minutes left to go in the half. Brian Quimby goes in motion, sets up in the slot on the far side. Landon Sims is going to keep it. Looking, got trouble. Lots of people are trying to get him. He runs out of bounds. No, he stays on his feet, runs out of bounds near the far side down marker.
I think he's going to be first down. Good run right there.
Look at Landon Sims dancing on the sideline, buddy. Oh, my gosh, I got it.
Sims went to go out the first time. There was nowhere to go. He backs up, comes back this way.
I just noticed, for those that are viewing, Tripp Carr's on the sideline, quarterback from last year. Must be an assistant.
He's an assistant, yeah. He's offensive coordinator, I believe.
Third down and inches, Cougars have it. Ball's on the 33-yard line.
We need a score.
We got twins to the far side and single wide out to the near side. Sims from the shotgun. Here's now we have Chase Bell in motion to the near side.
We got timeout.
Timeout's called.
Cougars.
By the Cougars. That's the last timeout the Cougars have this half, and they've used it. With 9 minutes, 51 seconds left to go, they're going to take 60 seconds to talk about it, and we'll take 60 seconds, head back to WBZR 105.9.
Those who are joining on YouTube and Facebook, we appreciate your comments. I do ask that you keep them clean. If I see any comments that are not appropriate, I'm going to have to remove you from the stream. So just ask y'all to please be thoughtful of your comments. Appreciate you chiming in.
Spence, I will talk in a minute about Hook's Barbecue. We stopped there prior to the ball game, and we look forward to coming to Hook's every year. We actually discovered it last year and said every time we come to Troy, we're going to have to eat there. It's great.
It's definitely good. That was my first experience there.
I'll tell you one thing, though. When they say they ask if you want hot barbecue sauce, it's definitely hot.
Just blocked my first user on YouTube.
Third down and inches. Ball's on the 33-yard line. We have single wide out to the near side, twins to the far. Looks like Sims keeps it up the middle, gets across to the 27-yard line. He needed a foot. He got about 4 yards. First down and 10. Cougars get a new set of downs as the sticks move.
Looks like Cougars going up tempo here.
We got Quimby in motion. Sets up in the slot here. Landon Sims looking to pass. Got Ty Williams open in the end zone. Touchdown! Woo! Beautiful pass. Beautiful throw. Beautiful route.
27-yard touchdown pass to Ty Williams.
You could not have laid that pass in there any better than Landon Sims' pass. Man, that was gorgeous. So the Cougars answer with a touchdown of their own with 9 minutes, 35 seconds, showing in on the clock for the second quarter. Now we have Orlando Medina set to attempt the point after. Snap, hold, kick up, and good. Ball game is tied.
No, ball is no good.
No good. Now, from here, it looked like it went through, but apparently not.
I'm going to tell you, it looked like it from here, our vantage point, but it landed to the left side of those stairs up top, so I don't know.
Oh, I guess not.
I don't know how.
Now, I will go ahead and admit we are at an odd angle today and with a little bit different conditions, so things may not always be what they seem, especially when it comes to goals.
Well, we used our last timeout, and it seemed to be productive, so we need to get a few more timeouts. It seemed to be working for us when we call them.
I don't have my histories with me, but I think this is the first time either one of these teams at this point during the game. Such a low-scoring game.
Yeah, we expected it to be a good game. Two good defensive teams.
So with 9 minutes, 35 seconds left to go in the half, Autauga leads by a score of 7-6. Cougars get set to kick it away. Now the Cougars do get the ball back in the third quarter. but there's plenty of time left in the second to be talking about that.
That short field that Otauga gave us after that extra point really played to our favor on that drive.
I don't know. I believe Ty Williams could have run another 300 yards if he wanted to.
Yeah, coach has been waiting on that play. He caught the cornerback sleeping with Ty's speed. You just don't recover from that. Landon's very, very precise with his pass, and he just put it right on the money, and it was just nothing they could do.
Landon Sims is a sophomore, but plays like a well-seasoned senior. Kicks it away. Medina is going to be received back near the goal line. Brings it out to cross as the 20 to the 20.
Petey McCants just come through there and hit the back, and he went flying through the air.
Superman.
I saw the back flying through the air, and we end up landing. Took an awkward landing. I'm really happy he was not injured.
I wonder what the field looks like from that vantage point.
I don't know, but I talked to Coach pregame, and he said they've really been working on tackling low, and I'm seeing it tonight, this afternoon, and I'm telling you, it's working. And backs can't go nowhere without their legs under them.
First down and 10. The ball is on the 22-yard line deep in general territory. Generals have it. Twins being sent to the far side. Palmer in the shotgun. Back Cutler behind him. It's going to be a toss in the backfield. And he's hit and stays on his feet. Lost, shook off the tackle. Another tackle second off. Brings it out to the 29-yard line for number 4. It's finally brought down. That was Teddy Harris, the running back. Just couldn't bring him down.
That was Bryant Quimby that hit him about 5 yards back, and the back just grabbed him by the face mask and just was twisting his face, and should have been an offensive face mask there, but apparently our vantage point's a little different. Anyway, he broke free and got a nice little gain out of it.
7-yard gain brings up 2nd down and 3. Ball out near the 30-yard line. Palmer from the shotgun, Cutler behind him in the backfield. Here's a snap. Hands off. No. Shakes the face of the Cutler. Looking to pass deep. Got a man
way downfield.
But overthrown by 5 yards. The intended receiver was number 6, Raymond Cutler.
And there's a flag on the play. And I'm sure it's probably going to be against us.
We will see. We're waiting.
Sims is pointing in the Tigers'
holding
direction.
Hold against the Generals, that'll back them up. We'll take it. That backs the Generals up way back, all the way to the 19-yard line.
14-yard line.
2nd down, 18 to go. Otauga leading by 1. At 8 minutes, 37 seconds left to go in the half. Palmer in the shotgun, flanked to his right by Cutler, the big running back. Spread formation.
He's incomplete pass. He just was able to dump it off to number 6 right there. It hit the ground just before number 6 could make the catch there. But that was who was that in on there? Had him by the feet.
I don't know.
Jason Helton, I think it was. I think it was Jason Helton in there.
It happened so fast, I wasn't ready. Brings up 3rd down now and 18. Let's see what the Generals come out. I'm sure they're going to do something long pass. We have the spread formation.
I like we got the nickel package in on defense here.
Sending a man in motion to the far side. Palmer looking deep in the pocket. Looking deep. Man got pressure. Decides to keep it.
Got him.
And he's brought down around the 18, 19-yard line.
I saw him this morning at Shoney's, and I said, are we going to call your name a few times tonight? He said, I hope you call it every play.
Jason Helton got in there and got the quarterback. He picked up, 2 yards on that play, 3 yards? And they got 4th down. They're sending their punt team out. But, hey, guys, don't be we expect them to do something funny here, so.
We don't trust the punt by Otauga. We've already established that. Coach has definitely informed us that that's not something you trust. Looks like they are going to try to punt it away this time. A spirally punt. Going to be fair catch was called at the 40. They threw the little beanbag down at the 41.
40, 40.
So the Cougars will start Their next offensive series, first and down, first and 10 from their own 41-yard line. They will be traveling from left to right. Cougars trailing by one with 7 minutes, 44 seconds left to go in the half. Cougars come out showing twins on the far side with a single wide out to the near side. Sims from the shotgun, hands off to Dalton McGee in the backfield, takes it up the middle, still on his feet, presses forward all the way out to the 47. No, 45, I think that's where they backed him up to.
44.
He got a lot further than I, well, he didn't get quite as far as I thought he did. That picks up four on the play, brings up second down and six. Ball's on the 44-yard line. Tyquell Taylor wide out on the far side along with Tyler Cloud. Ty Williams, receiver on the near side. Sims from the shotgun. Fake to his right by Shannon Weeks. Sims going to keep it, try to bring her on in, cut back in the middle. Crosses the midfield line.
That's going to be a first down, but there's a flag, late flag coming in.
And he brought down as soon as he crosses the midfield line with a flag on the play in the backfield. Let's see what that's about.
That's going to be holding.
They're going to bring that one back. Holding's called against the Cougars.
Well, I'm just glad to see them throwing the flag and clean the game up a little bit.
Since it's a spot foul, it takes it all the way back to the 34-yard line.
Our fans are not too pleased. A few of those are standing on their feet expressing their aggravation.
As well as deserved.
Cougars this time, they have twins on the far side. Nope, trips on the far side. Single wide out the near side. Jabo Davis heading over to the far side. Sets up in the slot. Sims rolling out to the far side, looking deep. Decides he's going to keep it. He takes it across to the 45.
First down.
Almost to the 50. Did he get it?
Nope, they gave him a yard short. And there's another flag.
In the backfield.
This is hard to sit here and bite your tongue, folks. I'm telling you it is.
Holding called against the Cougars once again. These penalties are starting to kill us. One penalty every now and then, you can almost shake that off, but when you start getting back-to-back major penalties.
Well, the thing is, it's almost like they're waiting until the play develops. That flag came out very late.
Second down and 26. Ball on the 24-yard line.
Look who's coming in. Number one.
Shannon Wheat just checked in. Trips on the near side. That's Ty Williams, Cloud, and Dalton McGee. Empty backfield. We got twins at the far side. Sims going to take it up the middle. Kick out. Stays on his feet. Crosses all the way out to near the 40 to the 39-yard line. That was a nice game, but still stays behind the sticks.
About a 14-yard gain on that play.
Third down and 11. Ball's now on the 39-yard line. Cougars have 11 to go. Got to make it all the way out to the midfield line.
Sims looks a little.
He's a little winded. He's had two long runs there. We don't have any timeouts there.
Play clock winding down. 10 seconds on the play clock.
Big third down right
Six,
here.
Five, four. Come on, Sims, get the ball off. 3-2, and it's not going to happen.
Yes, he got it off.
Does he get it off? He's going to keep it this time. Crosses the 40. Hit. Stays on his feet. Spins off of a tackle. Makes it out to the 44. He's brought down at the 44-yard line.
Sims is slow to get up over there.
Sims picks up five on the play. He's going to make it fourth down and six. Ball's on the 44.
Punt team's in.
Oh.
Yeah, you just about have to punt it away here.
He's going to have to. He can't punt. He's trying to signal for somebody to go in. Where's Medina at, Coach?
I'm hoping Sims just winded.
Medina doesn't have his helmet on. Yeah, I think he's just
winded. Play clock's ticking. 6-5. Punts, it's off. It's going to be fielded at the 20-yard line. Tried to bring it up the far side and nailed by number 22, Dodger McGee, knocked out of bounds. Looks like it's going to be spotted around the 31. So the Generals get the ball back. 4 minutes, 41 seconds left to go in the half. Leading over Scammy Academy, 7-6.
Very physical game.
There are going to be a lot of ice packs across the board on both these teams.
You know, you worked hard all season to get here, though. You got to leave it all out on the field.
I'm thinking about getting me an ice pack just watching the ball game.
Oh, my gosh.
First down and 10, Generals have it from their own 31-yard line. Sims this time out of the ball game. Twins the near side, now man in motion to the far side. Palmer takes the ball, hands off to his running back in the backfield. Hit immediately and brought down at the line of scrimmage. No gain on that play.
Like J-Bo Davis is on that stop.
This has been a high-intensity ball game, and the Cougars are not letting up. Second down and 10. Clock's at 4:16. Generals are sending twins to the near side with up and far side. Palmer from the shotgun, flanked to his left by his running back. Man in motion, that's Cutler. Look at the pass, hits Cutler on the screen pass. Looks like Ty Williams goes for the tackle, another missed tackle back around the 30, but run out of bounds.
Right down by Chase Bell.
Brings up third down and 10, no gain on that play. Cougars done a great job of containment on that screen play.
Yeah, Williams had him in the backfield. The guy stiff-armed him and he couldn't make the tackle.
And I have to say, that was a good stiff arm, even if it was against us.
It was a loss of a couple on that play.
A loss of two, isn't it? Third down and 12, ball's on the 29 now. Spread formation. Palmer from the shotgun, man in motion to the far side. Looking to pass, another screen pass. Trying to hit the slant.
Holding.
As he coming across the middle. It's caught and brought down at the, 39?
And J-Bo got a hold to him there. He bobbled the ball as it came across the middle, and J-Bo got him, and he stopped the forward progress. I don't know where they ended up spotting it at.
I don't know how
flag
he
on the field.
Stayed with the ball. How he hung on to it.
It was very, very. It took a lot of concentration. He bobbled it a couple times. It's going to be against the Tiger. That's going to back him up. I'm not sure what the call is. Probably holding. Yeah, it's a lot of holding going on. I'm glad the refs are starting to call it now.
That ball must have bobbled just in the right direction because I don't know how he kept control, but he did. Nonetheless, all for naught. Backed up all the way now to the 16-yard line. Third down with 25 to go. Big third down play for the Cougars defense.
Got some trip Coach Carr's out there trying to send in the signal.
If the Cougars can pin the Generals back deep in their own territory with 3 minutes and 35 seconds left to go in the half and get the ball back after half, that's not a bad situation to be in. Red formation, looks like.
They didn't get it off.
Timeout
called. They were sending Freeman in the quarterback position.
Big third down right here. Cougars can hold them, force the punt. We should get the ball back around midfield. There's enough time, we can score.
Yeah, there's enough time to work with. The only problem is we have no timeouts.
Well, if we can just get us in the Medina range, let him try it.
Now, that's one thing I haven't got to see enough of this year. Orlando Medina, number 7 for the Cougars, left-footed kicker. Orlando, I've actually personally watched him put a 54-yard field goal through the uprights with plenty of room left to go. There's a lot of faith in his leg, at least on my part.
Look for some kind of trick play here.
Third down, Autauga approaches the line of scrimmage. Number 10 in the quarterback position. That's Tyreshan freshman. Freeman. I keep saying freshman.
Got the nickel package in again.
Man in motion to the far side. Freeman back to pass. Another now he's pressure. Got pressure. He's taking it forward. Runs into his own man and brought down at the 22-yard line.
I'll give J-Bo and trying to see who that other one is. Randall Bonds credit for that stop.
There was a hole there, but he bumps into his own man and broke his momentum, and that allowed us enough time to grab him and bring him on down. This brings up fourth down and 20. Ball on the 21-yard line. Number 4, Teddy Harris back to punt it away for the Generals. Standing on his own 9-yard line. We have motion. It's going to be a
short
end of end punt. Going to take a general bounce all the way out. Just shy of midfield, about an inch.
Cougars did their job. We got the ball at midfield, 2:32 to go in the first half. We can get us about 20 good yards right here. We can get in Medina range. Big stop right there for the defense.
Cougars take over at midfield. Ball right on the 50. Placed on the near side hash mark, or just outside the near side hash mark. Chase Bell and Ty Williams is wide out on the near side. That's Tyquell Taylor and Daughtry McGee wide out to the far side. Sims in the shotgun, flanked to his left by his running back. Here's a snap. Hands off up the middle to Shannon Wheat. Shannon Wheat busts the hole, tosses the 40 to the 40, 35, tosses the 30 when he's brought down at the 29-yard line. Wheat has got acceleration, my friend.
And that's that 20 yards right there we needed.
He went from 0 to 60 in half a second.
He's a hard runner, too.
I'm not going to be able to keep up calling 50, 40, 30. I'm going to have to just bounce about every 25, 30 yards when he takes off running because I can't keep up with him. He can run faster than I can talk. From a spread formation, Sims from the shotgun. Hands off, no, fakes it, keeps it, takes it over the left tackle, got a little room, gets into the backfield, crosses the 20-yard line, but the flag comes flying out from the backfield. That's going to be a holding call and brought back.
I'm thinking they're going to call it on J.J. Stevens. I didn't see it, but I saw 88 over there with his hands up.
Golly.
Good play. That stung a little bit.
We need to figure out who's doing that and cut it out.
Brings the ball back to the 40-yard line. First down and 20, ball on the 40. Crowd showing that they're not real pleased with the call, but the officials make it. That's their prerogative.
That's the beauty of living in America. Everybody paid the same amount to get in here, and they can express their opinion.
Trips on the near side, twins to the far side. Empty backfield.
7-6-5.
Here's a snap. Sims looking to pass. And he finds Dr. McGee around the 35-yard line. He catches and runs out of bounds. Stops the clock.
It's going to be a couple yards short of the first down.
Well, we're still way behind the sticks.
Oh, that's right. My bad.
I saw the same thing.
That was a 5-yard completion, 6-yard completion.
Second down and 14, ball on the 34. Staying in the same formation. Sims all by himself back there. Play clock's ticking down, 12, 10. Deep in the pocket, got pressure. This time he's going to keep it. Runs up the middle, got a little room, and finally brought down. It's after crossing the 30 to the 28-yard line. Looks like his momentum where he was finally brought down in his forward progress stops.
That was close to a horse collar
it
right
was
there
close.
By 11.
It was a close. When you see someone's this whole
direction of travel change, yes. When somebody's got them by the shoulders, it's very close,
wrong.
Very close there. All right, big third down right here, 3rd and 8.
Cougars like this formation. They're staying with it. 55 seconds left to go in the half. Sims from the shotgun looking to pass.
Holding.
Got pressure. Holding called. Sims stays on his feet and brought down at the 20, but it's coming back.
Yeah. Oh, my goodness.
That was Randall Bonds on the end. Number 88 just beat him there, and he just kept him off of him. That was a good call.
For a second there, I thought Sims recognized that, was just going to try to down it.
Yeah, I did too. I'm glad he didn't, because they could have declined it, and it would have been fourth down.
I think if now is any time we need to score and get the ball back and score again to change the complete momentum of this game.
Yeah. We do get the ball back after halftime, so that's a good thing. We have 43 seconds left to go in this half.
I'm going to tell you, Otauga hasn't been tested like this. I mean, they're usually blowing them out by now, and they put it on coast after halftime, but it's going to be four quarters of physical football played here today. I hope they came to play, because it looks like the Cougars did.
If we can just keep our main players from getting hurt, we'll be all right. Sims all by himself in the backfield with three on the near side, two on the far side.
Five, four, three, two.
Does he get it off? And he does. Looking to pass. Keeps it.
Quarterback
Sims
draw.
Takes it up, hit at the 40-yard line. Momentum takes him to about the 38, where the whistle's blown, and he's brought down. Makes it fourth down.
8 seconds to go. 6-5 clock's running. That's going to do it for the first half here, folks.
First half now in the history books. Otauga goes into the locker room up by one, leading by a score of 7-6 over the Scambia Academy Cougars.
Some quick stats here for the first half. Escambia Academy has 104 rushing yards, 34 passing yards for a total of 138 total yards. Otauga has 47 rushing yards, 69 passing yards for a total of 116. So right now, statistically-wise, Escambia Academy is outplaying Otauga. The biggest thing that's killing us is the penalties. First half penalties, Otauga had four penalties for a total of 45 yards, and the Cougars had five penalties for a total of 50 yards. So it's pretty well evenly matched there. No turnovers thus far. Right now, got a host of Cougars with a couple of tackles. Nobody really sticking out, making plays dominantly. It's a team effort, and that's what we wanted to see today, is the boys that came to play for four quarters.
And I can tell you this, Spence, and I was talking to Coach Fields a couple weeks ago, and I told him, I said, Coach, this is not the same team we had at the beginning of the season. At the beginning of the season, we were just nowhere near the team that we are now. We've grown over the course of the season. We've grown, and you can see it materialize every game, getting stronger and stronger, and that's what gets you to places like this.
Yes, it does. We'll go over a scoring recap here. Otauga started their drive at the 42, and they finished it off with a 10-yard touchdown run by number 10. I didn't catch his number. Freeman.
That's Freeman.
Yeah, and the Cougars scored to answer back. Well, extra point was made, and that led 7-0. And the Cougars scored back with 9:35 to go in the second. They started the drive at Otauga's 36. And they drove, we had the long 27-yard touchdown pass by Ty Williams. And that's pretty much been it. Every other drive has been the Cougar defense forced a turnover on downs on Otauga's first drive. And every other drive there thus far has just been a punt, ending in a punt. So pretty flawless game thus far. Hopefully Coach will make some adjustments in halftime and try to clean up some of these holding penalties. And we got two more good quarters to play, folks. We're going to take a break.
I will tell you this before we go to break, though, Spence. I look at the numbers and I see our total yardage. That doesn't account for how many times we had to. We take one step forward, two steps back. So we had to make up these yards
each time.
So although 138 shown on the stats, we probably had to gain twice that, it seems like. We're going to take 18 minutes head for a break, and send you back to WBZR 105.9. We'll see you in 18 minutes to start the third quarter here at Veterans Memorial Stadium in beautiful Troy, Alabama. This is Ben White along with Tim Dewar and Spence Overton, See you in 15, 17 minutes.
Thank you. what are we going to do about Facebook? Everybody got to catch over YouTube? What happened? You got copyright.
That white stuff got on my
head.
Huh? Yeah, he's doing a halftime interview.
We have 7 minutes left to go before the third quarter is underway. We just sent our Action News reporter, Tim Doerr, down on the field to try to catch Coach as he comes back in to do a quick interview. Tim's always looking to improve the broadcast. And right now he's dancing down there for Ditto Gourmet.
I missed it. Hopefully he'll do it again.
Spence is temporarily operating the camera. There he goes.
I got him this time.
Tim, I'm glad you've done that again, and let us have an opportunity to catch you, because that's going to go down in EA history for many, many years with many, many views, I'm certain.
Yes, it is. While we're waiting on Tim, he's down on the sideline trying to get a halftime interview with Coach. Our statistician, Mr. Ronnie Cloud, sent me some halftime stats. They're pretty impressive. So I want to go over a few of these. It's a pretty evenly matched game so far. First downs, Otauga has 7, Cougars have 5. As I said before the half, I went over the rushing yards. Otauga is 10 for 14 on passes, and Cougars are 2 for 3. One being that big catch by Williams. Trying to read through the stats here. Punts, they've had 2 punts for an average of 35 yards. We've had 2 punts for an average of 27 yards. No turnovers thus far. Penalty yards, must have missed a few. 4 for 54 against Otauga and 7 for 75 against the Cougars. Time of possession here. Otauga's had the ball for 13 minutes and 22 seconds, and the Cougars have had it for 10 minutes and 38 seconds. Third down conversions, Otauga's 3 of 7, and the Cougars are 1 of 4. And fourth down conversions, Otauga is 1 for 2, one being that big stop on downs down around the 9-yard line. And Otauga has been in a red zone twice, only scoring on one of those.
Now, you bring up that goal line stance early in the ball game. You take that away, and it's a different ball game.
It's a different ball game. And, you know, the Cougars defense, they drove to occasion a couple times and got the ball turned over on downs and stopped them and forced punts. And that's big because Coach Carr, he don't like to punt. He wants to be in control of the ball all the time. leading rushers for Escambia Academy is Landon Sims. He's had 8 attempts for 50 yards, well, 48 yards. And Shannon Wheat has touched the ball 3 times for a total of 38 yards. Daughtry McGee has touched the ball 3 times for 12 yards. And Jabo Davis has ran the ball 1 time for 6 yards. As I said earlier, Sims is 2-3 in passing, longest being a 28-yard strike to Williams. Williams has got 1 reception for 28 yards and a touchdown. And the other pass completion was to Daughtry McGee for 6 yards. Leading tacklers the first half, Jason Helton has 6 total. Ty Williams has 3. Jabo Davis has 3. And Chase Bell has 3.
Just over 3 minutes left to go in the half.
Just a recap on the scoring drives. Otauga's Freeman scored on a 10-yard run with 46 seconds to go in the first quarter. Extra point was good. Give Otauga a 7-0 lead over the Cougars. And 9:35 to go in the second quarter. The Cougars answered back with a 28-yard strike from Sims to Williams. Medina's extra point was no good, and that leads us to where we're at now, 7-6 at the half.
While we're taking a moment at a couple more moments of halftime, I'll remind you tonight you can catch live as the Flemington Hurricanes take on the T.R. Miller Tigers in the third round of the playoffs. It's going to be brought to you on WPFL 105.1. And the Cougars make their way back onto the field. Tim's actually down on the field waiting to talk to Coach. I think we're going to go to him. Hey, Spence, I think Tim's waiting after you to go to him.
Hey, I'm on the wrong camera here.
Sorry,
on the
iPad,
slide
this to the
bench. Tim, look up.
They can't hear me, though.
Sign and don't like
they can't hear me.
I'm over on you, Tim.
Coach.
Okay.
All right, Tim's going to Coach Sims here, folks.
Live on the field, afternoon reporter. That's Tim Dewar interviewing Coach Sims. This is the first
time
we've done this.
Halftime show. How you feel the first half went?
As we welcome the Cougars back onto the next, field.
What are you doing the next half?
Got to cut out opportunities. See Coach Fountain making his way out of the tunnel.
Sun's done made his way behind the stadium now, so the stadium looks much darker, and the lights are the primary source of
let's grab Coach Fountain real quick.
On the field, there's no more sun, no more of a factor whenever you start looking up to try to catch a pass. Now the lights are on.
And I see Coach Fountain.
Coach, heck of a performance in the first quarter. What'd you tell the boys?
Myth, the legend, Coach
Fountain. We made way too many mistakes. I mean, penalties just killed us in the first half.
To this stadium.
You know, we get a good drive, we get a good game, then we lose 10 yards because we got a penalty hold, you know. But it's a tough battle up front. They're very athletic. We know we just got to keep battling in the second half, and if we do that, I think we'll come out okay. But just got a lot we got to take care of here.
All the fans up here and other fans watching, heck of a game. Keep on driving. Let's go home and get the championship.
Thanks, Tim. Appreciate it,
Coach.
Sorry, folks, I'm not the technical guru here, so the camera may be a little bit bumpy as Tim makes his way back up. I don't know how to get this off. He showed me how to get it onto the screen, but not off of the screen.
He did not show you how to get it.
So he's getting a live action shot at some of the fans as he makes his way up to us.
I'm quite certain we have more electronics than most TV stations.
I would agree with that.
Folks, you take Tim Dewar out of this equation, we ain't, me nor Tim or Spence, have any idea how to plug up any of this stuff.
We can talk to you on a cell phone, but that's about as far as we can do it.
We'll get Tim mic'd back up here in a second and find out a little more of what Coach said because I couldn't hear.
I couldn't either.
Like 2 minutes, 21 seconds left to the third quarter. It's now 71 degrees here in Troy, Alabama. It's we're going to have a stiff 9 miles an hour wind coming out of the south.
We don't feel it down in this hole.
No, we're up under the canopy of the home side of the stadium.
That was a great first half of football. The fans are getting their money's worth.
Spence, I don't know. Did you catch any of the unicorn meteor shower last night?
I read about it and it slipped my mind. So, no, I did not go outside.
I actually walked outside because I kind of like that type of thing. And there was too many clouds in the sky to see anything, so I walked back in.
Gotcha.
Were y'all able to hear the halftime?
We was not.
No.
Okay.
We were not.
Yeah, once I went to that one camera, I think it monopolizes the audio. But coach said, both coaches said, penalties.
Well.
That's not surprising. Hopefully that won't be much of a factor in the second half. If you're just joining us, the Cougars are trailing by a score of 6-7 right now to Otauga. Halftime's just about over. We're about to start the third quarter. The Cougars did win the toss pregame and elected to defer to the second half, so we will get the ball back.
For those that are on the Facebook stream, and just curious what you thought of, were you able to hear the audio from Coach Fountain? If you can, just chime in the chat session, let us know.
So that overrode us? Or could
it did. When I told y'all to go live to me and it went program, y'all's audio should have gone blank.
Okay.
Sorry.
Here comes the Cougars, folks, as we get ready to start the third quarter.
The one thing to remember, every one of these seniors on this field, this is the last game. This is the last half of the last game of their high school career.
Some of them will never play the game again.
As I said, it's a great game. There's a lot of kids on that field that know it's all from last year. They know the freshmen, they know that they're out for the business. They might be interested in how they respond to certain games.
Stop it. Bobby runs the same play, right low tackle, flags fly out. He stopped around the 45, and he's back to throw down. Sims. Wheat lines up to the left of Sims. Here's a snap. Looking to pass. He is. Got pressure. Throws.
Holding again.
Holding number call, but he's a sack. He's brought down.
Number 22.
Around the 26, but I think that's going to be a holding call as well, Spence.
Willie Willis was in there on the sack. There was a flag for holding. I'm sure Tauga will probably decline the penalty.
We got some fans off and showing their disagreement, I guess.
I can't say I agree with them. I mean disagree with them. Yeah, they declined it and took the sack. Gonna bring up third and 12.
Yeah. Third down 12. The Cougars have it deep in their own territory. Penalties being a big factor in to start the third quarter.
Well, you know, our sideline is pretty loud, but I don't hear very much out of that Tauga side. I think they're all in shock over there. They don't know how to come out in it after halftime and being a one-point ball game.
All right, let's see if we can keep our momentum up with the flags. We done made five first downs, ball brought back.
It's hard to beat the
ref,
too.
Here we go, Sims going to keep it this time. Take it around the far side, run, trying to hit the sidelines, but doesn't quite get there, and he's knocked down behind the line of scrimmage. That's going to make fourth down and even longer.
Apologize, what? Folks. It looks like right after halftime we had an audio issue, but that's been resolved. Appreciate y'all letting us know.
We had what?
Audio issue at halftime when we added the camera back on.
Oh, I got you.
You're good.
So the Coach Fountain interview was not on there?
No, it was on there, but when my second camera that's pointing to the scoreboard went down a while ago.
very close to being blocked there.
It's going to bounce at the 50 and knocked down by Chase Bell to keep it from bouncing back across the 50.
I tell you, that was only about a 19-yard punt.
We need the defense to stand up here and intercept.
21-yard punt.
It would be a great place for a pick six right now, Spence.
Yeah, defense needs a turnover right here. Biggest thing is we just got to clean it up. I mean, we're doing everything we need to do. Just the refs keep throwing the flags out, and apparently we're doing a little too much on the field.
All right, Otago comes back. That's number 14, Palmer, back in the quarterback. Twins on the far side. Hands off to his running back in the backfield. He cuts it up the middle. Jabo Davis will knock him down after crossing the midfield line to the 45. 44-yard line is where he's going to be spotted. Second down and three. That's a 7-yard gain.
Looked a lot more than that. Huh?
Spread formation showing this time. Palmer from the shotgun. Now we got a man in motion to the far side. Here's a snap, looking to pass, looking deep. Got a man open, way deep. If he hits him, he does. And Wheat knocks him down right before he gets out at the 1-yard line.
And Wheat's slow to get up over there. There's
flags on the ground.
And I'm hoping it's holding. Holding against the target. Finally! Coming back. Folks, that one's coming back. We're finally getting a break.
As many flags as we've seen this game, that one actually does kind of feel a little better.
Yeah, it does. So if that makes the quiet and the talker crowd come to life.
Well, you know, the leading rusher is the one of the officials.
He definitely is.
And back to Otago, back up off after a big play, backs them back up into their own territory around the 43-yard line. That's second down and 16. Otago has it.
I look for Otago to throw the ball more the second half.
Palmer in the shotgun, got a single back behind him. That's number six, Cutler. Looking to pass, throws a screen pass off to the far side. And it's a foot race to the sideline. He knocks him out after crossing the midfield around the, I think he's
48.
End up on the 48, Cougar 48.
Ran out of bounds by Ty Williams there. Third and seven here.
It's a 9-yard gain. So we got third down and seven to go. Ball now in Cougar territory, 48-yard line. 7 minutes, 50 seconds, showing on the clock for the third quarter. Otago up by a score of 7-6. Spread formation, Palmer from the shotgun, looking, hands off, no, fakes, throws across the middle.
Oh, man.
And nobody there.
Petey McCants had a chance for the pick, but he just didn't see the ball coming, and he broke for the receiver. He was the only man in the area, and he had a chance to make a play, but he went for the tackle.
That's going to bring up fourth down and seven for the Generals.
I look for him to go here. I see some personnel change. They may be going to try to pin the Cougars deep right here. I expect a fake here.
I'm not sure Otago knows how to play this much of a ball game because they usually blow people out.
It's definitely a change for them.
Lots of motion on the offensive line. There's a little wobbly punt off to the right. It's going to take a general roll
and roll out
about the 11, maybe?
11-yard line. Big stop for the defense after giving up what appeared to be a touchdown call negated by the holding penalty. The Cougars stand and force the Otago Generals to punt the ball.
Cougars get the ball back, first and 10 from their own 11-yard line, going left to right. Cougars are trailing by a one-point score, 6-7 off of a missed point after.
Be a good time for a pass down the sideline to Williams. He got a lot of green grass in front of him. We've seen him do it before.
We got Bryant Quimby in the backfield next to Sims. Chase Bell and Ty Williams wide out to the near side. That's Tequil Taylor on the far side with Dr. McGee.
And timeout.
Timeout's called on the field
by the Cougars.
Cougars will burn their first timeout. Take 60 seconds, talk about the situation. We're going to take 60 seconds, head back to WBZR 105.9.
Let's take a moment to thank our sponsors, two set of sponsors, some are both. Press Box sponsor helped facilitate our new Press Box then and there in Canoe. Atlas Roofing, PNR Mining, Dirt Technology, Darwin Earls, Overton Electrical and Construction, Bondurant Lumber, Southern Wood Specialties, the Matthews Family, Randy Dobbins Builders, American Concrete, Sunbelt Rentals. Also, corporate sponsors kind of sponsor everything throughout the year. Alabama Tank, Diamond Gasoline, Dirt Tech. Dr. William Harris, Overton Electrical Construction, Reynolds Real Estate, Superior Petroleum Services, Sunbelt Rentals, United Bank, and you can always watch us at eacougar.com/live.
Thank you, Tim.
All right. Cougar fans, if you're listening via the internet, and particularly YouTube, do us a favor. Go smash that ravishing like button. Subscribe if you haven't already.